Hello everyone, today we are going to study Introductory Wave Mechanics, which is the first chapter of our quantum mechanics course, and today's our topic is inadequacies of the classical mechanics. Inadequacies means simply the limitations of the classical mechanics, or pitfalls of the classical mechanics, or simply the weaker point, weaker zones of the classical mechanics, we can say. So it is very important topic, because before initiating the quantum mechanics course, we must have to understand why there is the need of quantum mechanics. Because if we don't know why the quantum mechanics, because most physics was explained by the classical mechanics or classical theory, then why there is the need of quantum mechanics. So it is necessary for us to understand why is the need of quantum mechanics, or what are the inadequacies, or what are the difficulties, what are the problem with the classical mechanics. And we are going to discuss some topics regarding this topic. Firstly, we all know that the classical mechanics is based on the Newton three laws. We all know about that Newton three laws, and basically in these three laws, they consider that the concept of absolute mass should be absolute. It is not relative. Absolute space is also not relative. It is absolute, and absolute time, and also classical mechanics explains correctly the motion of celestial bodies, I mean to say like planets, stars, and astronomical bodies, and the bodies which are macroscopic, means larger bodies, as well as the microscopic bodies. Microscopic means smaller bodies moving with the non-relativistic speed. If the bodies are moving with the non-relativistic speed in the earth, it can be explained correctly by the classical mechanics. So till then, but what happens if there is the relativistic limit? For the relativistic limit, or if the particles are very microscopic, or if the particles are of very small size, then there is the difficulty. So now we are discussing some limitations, or simply the inadequacies of the classical mechanics. So the first inadequacy is the stability of the atom, because the classical mechanics not able to explain the stability of the atom. Because according to classical theory, it was supposed that electrons are revolving around the orbit, and they are accelerating. If the electrons are accelerating, they must emit the radiations. It implies that if the electrons are accelerating in the orbit, they must emit the radiation, and if they emit the radiation, they should lose the energy. It means that if they lose energy, then atom cannot be stable. This was the explanation by the classical theory, but in reality atom is stable. In reality, atom is stable, because it was explained further by the Bohr's theory, by the quantization of the orbit, where we consider that the angular momentum is integral multiple of s by 2 pi. Like that. First inadequacy is the stability of the atom. Another one is the black body radiation. I think this black body radiation is one of the milestone, one of the key factor towards the birth of quantum mechanics. Black body radiation, it was discovered by the Max Planck. Max Planck is also known as the father of quantum mechanics. Okay, he plays very important role for the development of the quantum mechanics. So in black body radiation, what happens? According to our classical theory, it was assumed that, it was supposed that the emission of the spectra from the black body radiation, we studied in our class 11th and 12th also, black body emit the radiations, and they are called the black body radiations. So according to classical theory, or simply we can call according to classical mechanics, the emission of black body radiation must be continuous. But Experimentally, it was found that the spectra which are emitted by the black body must be discrete. Discrete means integral value. Like discrete, you can say that angular momentum, for example, angular momentum mvr is equal to nh by 2 by, where n is the variable, where you can put n equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 like that. Okay, you cannot put 1.5 in place of n. The value of n will be whole integral value. That is called discrete. I mean to say, like angular momentum equal to h by 2 pi or 2h by 2 pi, 3h by 2 pi, like that. So this is the meaning of discreteness. Discreteness means fixed value. Okay, so I already told you that later on Planck introduced the first quantum theory on the black body radiation. This is very important topic for the upliftment of the quantum mechanics. Okay. Now also another one is variation of the specific heat capacity. Variation of the specific heat capacity of the metals and gases. In classical theory, it was assumed that the specific heat capacity of the metals and gases are not dependent to the temperature. It could not basically here Dulang and Petit, the Dulang and Petit theory was there, which is regarded as the classical theory. This theory tells that the specific heat capacity holds true at high temperature. At high temperature, it works very well. The specific heat capacity is constant at the high temperature. But experimentally, it was found that the specific heat capacity strongly depend on temperature at low temperature region. At high temperature region, still experimental determination and this classical theory prediction is correct. But if we lower the temperature, if the temperature is decreased in the lower temperature region, the specific heat capacity strongly depends on temperature. It implies that specific heat capacity depends on temperature in the low temperature region. So that's why this is also a kind of difficulty which was not explained by the classical theory. This phenomena was later described by the Debye. The theory given by Debye is considered as the quantum mechanical theory also. And another one is classical mechanics could not explain photoelectric effect, Compton effect, Raman effect, Enamolas-Zeeman effect, and so many things, many more things. If you look after 1900, there were so many discoveries. Basically, most of the Nobel Prize were given on the quantum mechanics from 1900 to 1925. Okay, so these all the phenomena are very important. We all know about the photoelectric effect, what is photoelectric effect, quantum effect, but we will not go to very detail. Simply we are indicating what are the limitations also, inadequacies simply. And another one is ground state energy of the harmonic oscillator. According to classical theory, it was assumed that the ground state energy of harmonic oscillator is zero but experimentally it is not zero. The energy of harmonic oscillator is equal to h cut omega by 2. These are the phenomena. Classically the energy, ground state energy, should be zero, but experimentally it should not be zero. This is also one of the phenomena which was not explained by the classical theory. We need the quantum mechanical approach to describe it. Also, another one is enormous variation of electrical conductivity. The electrical conductivity have different values for different substances. The electrical conductivity, we know about the conductivity. It's just reciprocal of the resistivity. The electrical conductivity have different value. For different substance, the value of electrical conductivity is also different. This variation of electrical conductivity cannot be explained by the classical theory. For different substances shows the different kind of behavior, different type of electrical behavior, which was not explained by the classical theory. So this is also one of the limitation or inadequacy. Another one is the magnetic property of the material. The different material shows different type of magnetic behavior. Okay, so classical approach do not give the satisfactory description of such behavior. It means that different material have different type of magnetic behavior. They show different type of magnetic behavior. But classical theory not able to describe why this material shows this kind of magnetic behavior. So that's why we need the quantum mechanical approach to describe the magnetic property, because most of the magnetic properties are quantum mechanical in nature. That's why we need the quantum mechanics. Another one is the spin angular momentum. Spin is supposed to be one of the intrinsic angular momentum. Spin angular momentum is basically considered one of the intrinsic, one of the important of the elementary particle. For any elementary particle, spin angular momentum is one of the important parameter. So this spin angular momentum is basically the quantum mechanical in origin. In classical theory, there is not thing like spin angular momentum. That's why this is also a kind of limitation. If we describe the elementary particle, we must need the spin angular momentum, but this is not explained. There is no anything with the classical mechanics. So to explain the angular momentum, spin angular momentum, we need the quantum mechanics also. So these are the quantum inadequacies that we discuss over here. And later on, basically, I already told you that black body radiation, Planck's quantum theory for the black body radiation, was the milestone for the discovery of the quantum mechanics, which was around 1901. Okay, so and so many for the stability of the atom, Bohr's theory, that was angular momentum mvr equal to nh upon 2 pi. It means that. And this also the quantization of the angular momentum, that's very important. Also the selection rule in quantum mechanics also perfectly describe the atomic and molecular spectra. To explain the atomic and molecular spectra, these quantum mechanics, these selection rules are very important. So in this way we can discuss the inadequacies. After knowing these inadequacies, we will study so many things in quantum mechanics. It is one of the huge branch. It is one of the very important branch of the physics. So in coming lecture we will discuss another topic and new topics also. So for now, thank you very much.